Hello.
We made it another week. How are you?
What day is it? What month is it?
I don't know, but I just know, like, for some reason, 108, 9, 10-ish doesn't bother me to be in the pool and poolside all day.
Most definitely. I was telling my friends who are not from the desert, we don't get 120, 21, 22 very often, but when we do, we have it for a couple of days, and then it goes back down to 108, and you think it's air conditioned, right?
Right. And with our little waterfalls that we have, I mean, you want to be under that all day. So it still is delightful. And actually, I read and heard from friends that are realtors that real estate sales are up. Either because maybe prices are a little bit more, a little bit more agreeable to the buyer than they were, or people are looking to move out of the big city hubs and really have a place where they can have beautiful
space.
Air and, a nice life. I mean, we have friends that are here at a local hotel looking for property, moving from the Northwest.
People are looking.
Right?
Yeah, that's right. And one of the benefits of people who are looking, who either are here right now or people wherever they may be, whoever are watching us, if you watch us on Palm Springs Point of View, which is right behind me here, you will be able to see a variety of different shows and activities that go on here in the desert that are eats, arts, and culture oriented.
Right.
And it's a good way for people who don't live here to kind of keep up to date on what's happening in the desert. Let's talk about some of the things that are going on right now. Of course, you and Alan do your Tuesday through Friday piano bar with Alan and Claudia, which is always so much fun. I love the one the other, I think it was Thursday, with the comets flying by and that was just terrific.
Well, because we had Neowise, which is still circulating around our solar system. Coming closer and closer to Earth until Wednesday night, the 23rd, July 23rd, is when it's going to be the closest.
I'm going to try to watch.
Yeah, I think we can actually see it with a naked eye. Binoculars would probably be preferred.
I want to talk about a couple of virtual shows that are going on that focus a lot here in the desert that maybe some of our desert folks might be interested in. So there's an organization called Outlandish. They're all over the place, mainly in the LGBTQ communities, and they bring a lot of interesting drag performers, singers, gay and lesbian performers, and they this month went virtual, and I saw a variety of their shows. I want to quickly go over some of them. These are some of the folks that they had had shows today. I want to talk quickly about Coco Peru. So she did a show.
Yes, I love
she did
her.
A show called Casa Coco, where she did a variety of interviews with some friends of hers. I've seen a couple of her shows. I've always been okay with her, but she's really a very good interviewer. And she is somehow friends with Allison Jenny from Mom. And of course, yes, exactly.
Oh,
they are friends somehow. And they had a really nice, just casual conversation. And I love seeing a star who's really taking the starness away and just talking to her, their friend on camera, and really, really good little interview.
So cool.
Yeah. They also had, this is Varla Jean Merman. And she's
is she Ethel's daughter?
Maybe. she did another one of these talk shows. She interviewed a variety of her friends. Each one of them have their own style of interviewing. And, it wasn't bad. This one here is Miss Richfield 1981. I don't know if you ever heard of her. She is hilarious. And what was really fun about this, interview is that you could play bingo with her and a bunch of other people who are watching all over the United States. You get 3 bingo cards, and she calls bingo while she's telling stories and talking to people. And she's just a hoot. There's no cussing. There's no putting down other performers. It's just good darn fun. And she's really a blast if you get a chance.
Okay, I know how much you and Robert like games. Did you guys play?
We did play.
Did you win?
Somehow I managed to understand how to get the technology to work. And we played. We didn't win, but it's a blast. And I want to talk about a few more things.
Will she continue to do this? Can we all tune into this?
I'm going
to
tell you just one second. I'm going to go through two more people. So this is Michelle Johnson. This was the first time that she did a virtual performance. Her and her pianist, Bill Sapai, I think his name is. I believe this was her first time doing a virtual show. And as you know, Claudia, as I know, the first time in front of just a camera, it's a little nerve-wracking, a little hard to get used to, but you know, she's a great performer. So it was fun.
Nice.
Yeah, and then also how about this for some big hair, right? This is—
ooh, I'm not worried.
And then she was interviewing Mink Stoll, who is here, and Mink
Stoll— oh my God, Mink Stoll?
Well, Mink Stoll, of course, Mink Stoll's been in a lot of John Waters films, right?
Oh, with behind. Oh my God, the best.
And wait till you see this. This really shows you the period. Look at the style of clothing and just the type of camera work. It's very, you know, 60s, 70s. And
oh my
she's
God.
Been in all kinds of shows with John Waters. It was divine,
you
dude.
Can't wait.
Her best thing.
Fabulous.
That's a blast, right? That's again, is called Outlandish. And we're going to be able to post an email address that our viewers can get, send an email to the email, and then you will be on the list for future Outlandish events to be part of. Miss Richfield is doing a trivia event coming up where you can also participate, and that you can get that if you get on the email. So that's Outlandish. And it's they're a great group, very popular here in the gay community. Also fabulous. Doing virtual is, of course, the folks over at the CV Rep, which we all know about. I believe they recently said that they are not going to be bringing their series back until next year, but they're very smart. They're doing some virtual shows on Thursdays. And this past Thursday, they had this gentleman. His name is Josh Nelson. He's a composer and a pianist. He has performed at the CV Rep several times, and I believe their cabaret shows. He was performing from home. He's really, first of all, he's quite the looker, which is always enjoyable. And then he's a great pianist, and he has some great stories about people that he's looked up to, and he's performed some of their songs. He does not sing. He also toured at one time with Natalie Cole, very well known, and really a very interesting show to watch. So there's a lot of stuff going on, right? A lot of stuff going on. But I know that you recently were looking at the Palm Springs Life magazine, talking about things going on in the area.
Well, I mean, you know, people are not just sitting at home doing nothing. Aside right. from the CV Mass Project, I actually, you know, this new issue, which of course I want this, and we want to go where they are, right?
Of course.
Because why not? We know we're ready. So this particular black and white, like just whole photo editorial on life in the desert goes on, particularly struck me because, you know, you go through and you see your friends and what they're doing in the desert. And this is Melissa Morgan Gallery with her grooming her dog. She's up in the Pioneer Town with her dog.
Oh,
here
yes.
you see Deborah Hovell. I mean, she was mask making extraordinaire as far That's as right. the sewing went with CV Mask Project. And she's That's taking right. a little break.
She
but
was
I believe she, I mean, she was above and beyond. And then, you know, people are out, they're out and about, they're riding their bikes, they're going through town. I mean, it's nice. And
you know what, Claudia? It's proof that magazine is proof, and the show that we're doing here and the show that you do and other people are doing, it's proof that life has not ended. It's just different.
It's just different. Right? Yeah. It's
and
just
we're
different.
All doing our best to try to keep people entertained while they're at home in front of their TVs or doing whatever it is that they're doing. Today, we're going to feature a show that won. It's one of our film reviews that we did at the Mary Pickford Theater.
Right.
And talking about the best, it won 2 Academy Awards recently this past year for film editing and for sound, right? And that film currently, and one of the reasons we're playing it now, because it's currently playing on HBO. The other day, Robert and I came across it, and before you know it, we watched the whole thing again.
And you've already seen it, but
of course.
For any one of you out there who hasn't seen it or wants to look at our review coming up, Ford versus Ferrari was just, weren't we on the edge of our seats?
Yes.
Okay, so Claudia. Catch the review. Hope you love it. Great to talk. Great to chat, Conrad. Love to Robert.
Thank you. Likewise, over to Alan. And remember, we will see you soon. And we are, of course, Palm Springs Point of View. See you soon.
Bye.
How long we've known each other, Ken? I ever break a promise to you? I will put you in the driver's seat at Le Mans. You just shut your mouth and let me do my thing.
The film is called Ford versus Ferrari. That was my best impression of a race car shifting gears. This film is directed by James Mangold and written by brothers Jez and John Henry Butterworth. The film stars Matt Damon as Carroll Shelby, the former race car driver, now car designer, and Christian Bale as bad boy race car driver Ken Miles. This is a terrific biopic. If you like classic cars like the Ford Mustang, the Ford T40, the Shelby Cobra, the Ferrari, the 1960s race cars, this is the film for you. However, if you're not a race car enthusiast, don't worry. This is a good film with drama, energy, information. This is what a dramatic biopic should look like.
So I was not knowing what to expect when I went to see this film, because I thought the same thing. I thought, oh, race cars.
Race cars, okay. I'm with you.
But there's a lot of drama going on. And in fact, I just have to say right up front, I think Christian Bale's role as Ken Miles is Oscar worthy. Yeah. I was blown away. I think you guys will be too.
Well, he just got nominated for a Golden Globe.
Okay,
for this
so there we go. There we go. Exactly.
Yeah.
All right.
And this guy, Christian Bale, he is not afraid of putting on weight, taking off weight, putting on a character, taking off a character. I mean, this guy is really creative, and he does it especially in this film.
He really embodied Ken Miles, and he was almost like he was a go-for-nothing guy. I mean, he was not a team player,
and a lot
of this movie was about becoming a corporate team player in the world of Ford.
This film also has a great ensemble cast. I want to especially talk about Tracy Litt, who plays Henry Ford II in this film. There are sometimes in an actor's lifetime, there are roles where he or she gets one scene to do something that's amazing. This is a great role for this guy.
He goes for a ride.
Yeah, goes for a ride, right?
Yeah, and this is when they're, you know, it's all about them developing the GT to win the 24 hours of Le Mans.
Le Mans.
The 24 hours of Le Mans. That was the whole goal, to beat Ferrari.
Right.
And the reason they wanted to beat Ferrari was because they wanted to buy Ferrari. And I guess we could say that that didn't work out so well.
But they also wanted to beat Ferrari, who had been winning the Le Mans for the past, I don't know, maybe 6 years or 4 or 5 years, something like that.
Right?
Mm-hmm. So it was all of that coming together. One of the things I really enjoyed, I enjoyed so much about this film. I'm so happy when I get to enjoy a film. One of the many things I really enjoyed about
Conrad.
This film, I know it's rare, right? is the director in this film. He had the opportunity to, because it's about race car driving, many directors would have put the camera on the car and it would have been all about the shaking of the car and the car and the car and the car. This director did that every now and then, but he also took the camera away and let you experience what the cars were doing, what the race looked like.
So the 24 Hours of Daytona was the first race driven by Ken Miles that the GT actually performed. And there was like an agreement with Henry Ford that if he won that, then he got to go to the 24 Hours of Le Mans.
Exactly.
So that really, the whole climax is the 24 Hours of Le Mans and what happens during that race.
I don't know if you know, this film runs 2.5 hours. Did you feel that?
I did not at all, because when I found that out, you know, before I went to see the film, I'm like, how am I going to do this?
Sleeping time, but no, not in this
one. I didn't need a bathroom break. I couldn't keep my eyes off the screen.
Exactly.
I know. It was like, really, you know who I thought was great though? Their son.
The son, Noah Jupe.
Noah Jupe?
Right.
Yeah.
He's also in a current movie called Honey Boy, which is up for some consideration for Academy Awards.
And he was in A Quiet Place.
And in A Quiet Place. He's so good to look at, right?
Yeah.
He's just an interesting look, and he's such a great little actor. He listens and he watches and the emotions that he has. He's going to be someone we're going to be watching, that's for darn sure.
I know, right?
I read that there were actually 460 cars that were used and abused, as they say, in this film.
What a waste.
Because there were so many crashes and stuff. And one of the main crashes I really enjoyed, I wondered, how did they do that? And I saw some background on it. When one of the Ferraris is thrown into the air and almost crashes in front of a variety of folks. They actually shot a Ferrari from a cannon onto this raceway.
And you know, this was a fast, furiously fast movie, but there's also a really sad element
there
to it.
It is. Well, it's a drama. So let's rate this baby.
You go first.
I'll go first this time. So I will give this 5 out of 5 popcorns. This is a good one.
I think I'm giving it 4.5. Right. And only because of Matt Damon's character. He still was like Matt Damon to me.
Okay.
And that's a character thing, but I think as part of the story, I think he could have been a little stronger and more believable as Carroll Shelby. But Ken Miles, the film.
Yeah, good. Name of the film is called Ford versus Ferrari.